Welcome, this is EE Productions. Today, live on tape, and we are playing Phoenix 2. Specialist mission. I thought about doing something different today, because this specialist mission is about teleporters. And as you might know, teleporters are my absolute favorite type of ship. So, yeah, and here they are. Prime X, Tuimi, Aurora, Luna, and Trinity. And we will try to clear with each of the ships. So, the specialist mission, it's mission 522. We will face armored invaders with lasers, MRFs, and a Condor. Okay. Then, first, I'd like to start with Aurora. Aurora has high impact main weapon, bullet EMP, and teleporter, of course. And we'll use Tau Apex, which gives the quantum nuke a little bit of homing capability. Then, let's go. So Aurora's main, you can see in the field with little or with small invaders, the quantum nukes are really powerful. And they show their potential. On the other hand, you see, with larger enemies that are armored, like here, so they're having kind of a hard time. Oh, come on. Yeah, you take advantage of this the large blast range. Watch out for the laser. Okay. Good so far. And this ship takes an immense amount of quantum nukes. Yeah, it's always a pity when the quantum nuke misses. So since this is a teleporter ship and the topic of today's specialist mission, we should also use the teleporter. In the maxed version, it clears bullets on arrival. So that's useful here to clear this little group of MRFs. Simply by teleporting into them. Okay, this was too close. Yes. All right, let's try again. Oh, this was good. So at if the game switches between one act, I try to fly a little bit lower, which gives the quantum nuke more time to travel across the screen, and you have a better chance to actually hit the first wave in an act. Like this. Maybe in the editing I can do the counting how many nukes this were. Yeah, I remove those tumors because sometimes I don't watch at them and then they explode, hit me by surprise. So so good so far. That's right. We have plenty of time. It's gonna be a tough one. Here you see with the big enemies, Aurora is really having a hard time. Nearly 3 minutes. Yeah. You will see in comparison when you use an armor breaker ship how this works out. But for now, and so those lasers are a bit of a pain. One, two, three, four. This was good. Right in the crowd line, in the crowd of enemies. Good, next. And the nuke misses. Puh. should be okay. We have plenty of room to dodge. Well, why me not? So I try to teleport into those shriekings to clear a path. Ah. So, okay. I think we will be able to handle this type of lasers. There are not too many. Teleporter, it shouldn't overheat. How can it go right through? It's impossible. Those guys above there are a pain. Okay, so I will wait in the corner here, just to have to give the teleporter a chance to cool down. Okay, whew, so I stopped talking for a while. So I think it's under control now. Yeah. 5 minutes, boy. Oh, what a nice ranking. 1, 2, 3, 4. And nearly exactly 5 minutes. Okie dokie. So who's next? Next will be yeah, Trinity. Okay, Trinity is a armor piercing chip, the chrono field, and the teleporter. Well, here it says Trinity teleporter, because the special thing about it is that it fires a projectile on the rival, so it can do a little bit of damage. And we have two apex. We have what is it? Delta apex. Dark fire shot upon teleporter rival now deals blast damage. Oh, that sounds good. And let's go again. So for Trinity and the Chrono Field, the idea will be to save energy as much as possible. And then simply hop through the bullet, through the clouds of bullets. opportunity. It's for opportunity. It's also easier to pop a turret. So we will do this. It's also, I think one of the important strategies in Phoenix. If you have the larger enemies, try to remove their turrets as quick as possible. So here we will go for the Nerf turrets. Next the pellets. Okay. Now let's destroy the lasers first. Launchers. Act 5. Let's stay on the left side. Okay. You know what? Let's get crazy. So we used that method to clear the most annoying enemies in the upper part. Spawn. And this was Trinity. So we are already recording for 19 minutes. Let's hope the iOS screen recording will be able to handle it. Oh, you know what? Make a little cut here. Save, and then we are right back. Okay, next trip. Who's next? Next will be next, Dreamy. One of my absolute favorites. I think I used it in the early days of Phoenix when I was in the lower leagues, and Dreamy was also, yeah, my trusty ship to clear heavy missions. Trinity has a Shieldbreaker main weapon, missile swarm and teleporter, of course, and we have Tau and Gamma Apex. And in this mission we will go for Gamma Apex because it allows the missile swarm to pierce armor, and that's what we will need, because Twimmy's main weapon is kind of weak from the damage. If you look at the damage of 21.25, it's not a lot. We will definitely feel it in this mission, but the armor piercing missiles will be a big help. Let's go, Dreamy. Right. So the advantage of Dreamy's main the homing functionality, so you can concentrate on dodging, and the main will do the rest. On the other hand, it really takes a lot of time to actually destroy an enemy, especially the bigger ones. So this won't be a speedrun. So I, you know, take it easy here and try not to do too many risky maneuvers. You just want to clear. So I will save this missile spawn for the next wave. Like here. Oh, you know what? Let's try it. Once again, I want to save this missile spawn for the next wave. Yeah. Yuck. Okay. But the idea, I think, is it was good, right? So once we have cleared this welcome party, then I think it shouldn't be a big problem to deal with the condor. Maybe I shouldn't have done this teleporting into the upper part, because it will waste a lot of energy. This was too early. Ah, this was too early. Sometimes when I stop talking and it's something concentrated. In the blink of an eye, I thought Trinity had a bullet EMP. Big mistake. Relax, relax, relax. Go. Nah. So maybe here in this wave, it might be good to clear the upper enemies, because they really are annoying with the label, the triple lasers they have. Grace energy, because those pellets, they are very predictable. Yeah, those straight lines of pellets. It's a good opportunity to grace some energy. Also very often I do a combo of teleporting and the missile swarm. You know, so I choose a position on the screen, teleport to it and launch missile swarm immediately. Close. Prepare for the next wave. Okay, so the right side is free, on the other hand I overcharged my teleporter. What did I mean? That's okay. Yeah, heart rate monitor. 101. I can still feel the game, even after so many years of playing. So this was Dreamy. My trusty Dreamy. So next is Prime X, which is, I think, the king of armor missions. Because it first has a powerful main weapon that can pierce armor. It has also the missile swarm and the teleporter. And with that Epsilon Apex, we can also pierce armor with the missile swarm. So this makes Prime X, Epsilon Apex, a real killer for armor missions. Let's see how this works out. I think Dreamy was another, what was it, 30 seconds faster than Trinity. So the idea at Prime X, at least that's what I do. Let's clear one side of the missile swarm of a wave and the other side of the main weapon. So and here you also see the turret destruction with the main weapon, cause those MILF turrets had no chance to fire a single MILF. Is a beast. It really is. Oh, tracking laser. -32. Heart rate 97. So in comparison to 3ME, this was, I think you can see what this armor piercing capability brings. Then last but not least, we have Luna. Luna is a shield breaking ship with point defense and the teleporter. Main weapon is really powerful. It's one of the most powerful laser, one of the most powerful shield breaking ships with 37.5 damage output. And we will use Tower Apex, which enhances the bullet detonator to also destroy enemies. Cause the bullets, they explode and deal blast damage. So let's see how this works out. The thing about Luna's main weapon is that those 37.5 damage output are only achieved if you hit your enemies with all the lasers. So at the no, so those lasers form a narrow beam, but at the top of this beam, it doesn't have the full damage output. It's only at the lower part. So if you want to destroy enemies real quick, you have to fly and attack. Fly upwards and attack. Thank you. here. Let's destroy the shrieking launchers. Yeah. Okay, good. No. Let's chill a little here. Cool down the teleporter. And then let's get ready for the last wave. Now we collect all the energy that was stored in the upper part of the screen. Use the bullet detonator. And to come to a quick end. Okay, so this was the specialist mission with teleporter ships. So I hope you liked it. And this new live on tape format of video. So thank you very much for watching, for liking. Yeah, please hit like, please hit subscribe. And yeah, I see you next time. Bye bye.